Good morning. Look at you hardy folks. Getting out of the house when it's this cold, and it's going to get colder. But we give thanks to God in every season for the blessings that we enjoy and the blessings that even show up in our lives when we don't anticipate it. Welcome to all of you that are joining us from the warmth, hopefully the warmth, of your home. Know that God's grace and peace meets you where you are. So hello to all of you on the YouTube broadcast and on the TV Read broadcast later this week. Know that you are all invited to join us for Holy Communion as well, as God's grace meets us where we are, as we are. I invite you now to stand as you are able. This is the day that the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad.
We are gathered together as a people of God in the name of God, our Creator, our Redeemer, and our Sanctifier. Amen. Gathered as God's people, we know that community is important, that it is life-changing. And so we take this time right now to be connected to those around us, to say hello, good morning, and God's peace. So God's peace to you all. Peace, Joy. Good morning. We're doing elbows today? All right. No, me either. God's peace. God's peace. God's peace. I'm doing elbows today. Good morning. Good morning. God's peace. Good morning. God's peace. Good morning. I love you. God's peace. I'm going to go talk some more. No. Yeah, I love you too. We continue by stating why we are here. You can find this liturgy in your bulletin. We gather today in the light of Christ to offer our praise, our hopes, and our thanks, to be connected to you, O Lord, and one another. We are here to offer thanks. Gracious God, you have touched us and blessed us this past week in so many ways. We thank you. We are here to confess our need for God. Gracious God, you call us to grow in spirit and love, to serve your world. Help us be aware of your world's condition and offer hope. Help us to see our own brokenness and, as your people, attend to our neighbor. We are here to experience God's presence as part of community. Gracious God, you created us to be in community. There is joy and support as we gather. We see you in our neighbor's eyes. Our Lord is an amazing God who knows the joys and struggles of our lives. God claims us, leads us, and blesses us in our journeys to bless our neighbors. Rise, shine, for your light has come. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are able as we sing our opening hymn, Rejoice, Ye Pure in Heart.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Holy God, source of grace and renewal, you set us free from sin and set us back on your paths of righteousness and love. Forgive us when we fail to practice your righteousness. Turn our hearts back to you and send us into the world you love so that we may do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly as we follow your ways. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Testament lesson this morning comes from Micah chapter 6, verses 1 through 8. Hear what the Lord says. Rise, plead your case before the mountains, and let the hills hear your voice. Hear, you mountains, the controversy of the Lord, and you enduring fountains of foundations of the earth, for the Lord has a controversy with his people, and he will contend with Israel. O my people, what have I done to you? In what have I wearied you? Answer me, for I brought you up from the land of Egypt and redeemed you from the house of slavery. And I sent before you Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. O my people, remember now what King Balak of Moab devised, what Balaam son of Beor answered him, and what happened from Shittim to Gilgal, that you may know the saving acts of the Lord. With what shall I come before the Lord and bow myself before God on high? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams, with 10,000s of rivers of oil? Shall I give my firstborn for my transgression, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul? He has told you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you but to do justice, and to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God. The New Testament lesson comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 1, starting in verse 18. For the message about the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and the discernment of the discerning I will thwart. Where is the one who is wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the debater of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of the world? For since in the wisdom of God, the world did not know God through wisdom, God decided, through the foolishness of our proclamation, to save those who believe. For Jews demand signs, and Greeks desire wisdom. But we proclaim Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and a foolishness to Gentiles. But to those who are the called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and God's weakness is stronger than human strength. Consider your own call, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. But God chose what is foolish to the world to shame the wise. God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong. God chose what is low and despised in the world, things that are not, to reduce to nothing things that are, so that no one might boast in the presence of God. He is the source of your life in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God and righteousness and sanctification and redemption, in order that, as it is written, let the one who boasts boast in the Lord. Here ends the reading.
Please rise.
He went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We may be seated. At this time, I invite the kids to come forward while we sing.
This big light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This big light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This big light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Good morning, guys. Justin, Elena, Oscar. Hi. Hi. How are you? Good. Are you awake? Kind of. Okay, yeah, I know. You had a late night last night, didn't you? Why don't you all stand up on the top here? Come with you. All right? Come up here. Come up here, Justin. All right. Let's look out. What can we see?
People.
Does it look a little bit different because you're a little bit higher up?
Yeah.
Okay. I want you to try something. I see a clock. Yeah. That's my reminder to ramp it up. Let's try looking at it a little bit different way, though, okay? I want one of you, brave volunteer, to lay down on this chair and look at it upside down. You want to go first? Okay, you just sort of sit there first. You all get a chance, all right? So let's... I mean, I suppose you could, but... All right. Okay, does it look different now? Oh, the lights are way bright. Yeah, you got to watch out for those. Okay. Yeah, okay. Why don't you look at it upside down, Oscar? Don't worry, you'll get your turn too, Justin. All right. So look at it upside down. Don't stare directly into the lights. Yes. Okay, Justin, why don't you look at it upside down? They are, though. They really are. All right. Okay, now, don't look directly in the lights, okay? Okay. What do you notice? Yeah. Do you see anything you didn't notice when you were looking at it right side up?
Yeah, they're upside down.
Yes. Thank you for that. Did you notice anything? Did you see anything new? Other than upside down things? Oh, yeah. There are holes in the ceiling. Yeah, that thing's got up there. Yeah. Did you notice anything new? You can see closer up to the wood, yeah. All right. Did you notice anything new, Oscar? Yeah, you can kind of see the shape.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's lights under that too. Yeah. Okay, so I had you guys look at it upside down because Jesus says some upside down things today. Did you hear when I was saying blessed are the? Did you hear that part I just read?
No.
Yeah, thank you, daughter of mine. No. So it's Jesus said, blessed are the poor in spirit. Does being poor in spirit sound like a good thing?
I don't know. I don't even know what it is.
It's not the person who is.
Yeah, but Jesus says, blessed is that person. And then Jesus says, blessed are those who mourn. Do you know what does mourn mean? That's really sad. Yeah, it could be someone mourning for someone who died. Could be mourning something that's lost, too. Yeah, someone who's dead. Jesus says, blessed are they. Jesus said, blessed are those when people persecute you. Do you know what persecute means? It means, like, bully you for just being a follower of Jesus. Do those sound like good things? That kind of sounds like opposite day, doesn't it? So I want you to be right side up now. So here's what I want you to remember. Justin, here's what I want you to remember. Sometimes we see the world one way, and we think that's all there is. But God shows us a different way. Yeah, we change our perspective. And what God does is God helps us change our perspective, and God flips things around on us and reminds us that we are blessed, even when we think there's no possible way we could be blessed, given good things from God. So that's what we're going to explore today in the sermon as well. So let's say a prayer. You guys can repeat after me. Same with all of you. Dear God, turn our world upside down.
Turn hate into love.
Turn sadness into joy.
Turn us to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
All right, thanks for coming up here. You guys can go back to your parents.
I
know, go to your mom then.
such a tricky word. Blessing. It's a tough word. Because we think we know what blessing is. And we're half right. But what Jesus is doing in the Beatitudes is flipping it upside down. Is showing us still yet a deeper way to understand what it means to be blessed by God, to be loved by God, to be redeemed by God. Because that is what God has always been doing. Taking our human notions of what is right, what is the way things should be, and saying, look again. Look again. So we heard the reading from the prophet Micah. Now Micah was a contemporary of Isaiah, Amos, Hosea. In that time of Israel where they knew that bad things were coming. That Micah prophesied that, you know what, Israel, especially Jerusalem, you're going to be destroyed. Life is going to get really tough. And all the ways you think that you're living faithfully are not quite hitting the mark. What does the Lord require of you? Does the Lord require more burnt sacrifices? Does the Lord require more of giving from what you can do? No. But God has continually told us what is good. And if you have this one memorized by heart, what does the Lord require you but to do justice? Oh, yeah, we have an organ cipher. Great. It could be a very meditative tone. But what does the Lord require of you? To do justice, love, kindness, mercy, and walk humbly with your God. Now that is not what was expected. Necessarily, people thought that by returning to more sacrifice, more prescribed prayer, that was what God must be wanting. And God says, you're half right. What Micah is doing is proclaiming a blessed way of life, a way of whole living, not just the religious experience in the temple only. And then in Paul's first letter to the church in Corinth, it picks up where we were last week. The message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing. Well, what does that mean? I think it means it looks a lot like foolishness to those who are on the outside. To those who think that they've got it all together, and they're looking down at this group of people, this fledgling group of Christians, or people of the way, as they were called in that time. But Paul says, to those of us who know, to those of us who've experienced this, it is blessing. It is salvation. But even in that blessing, the church was struggling because there were divisions. If you remember from last week, people were saying, well, no, I belong to Apollos, or I belong to Paul, or I belong to Cephas. And they were fracturing this message. This message that blesses the whole world. Because that's always been the challenge for us as people of God. We get so hung up on our little clubs and our little specific ways of doing things that we sometimes, again, miss what God's blessings really mean for us in our lives and how we are called to go out and be people of blessing in the world today. We sometimes lack the language to even talk about it. How many of you have your elevator speech where someone asks you, what is the gospel of Jesus Christ? You can tell us right there. Does anyone? For God so loved the world, he gives him. That's good. That's a good one. It's a good one to go to. But we chuckle because, like, a lot, sometimes we do think, even pastors, I think pastors are notoriously bad at this. We get stuck in the weeds. And we forget how to proclaim blessing. We forget how to just say it. And so that is what I was thinking about as I again heard these words that I've probably preached on, I don't even know how many times now. Blessed are. These are called the Beatitudes. Beatitude means supreme blessing, like a big blessing. So Jesus goes up the mountain and he proclaims these supreme blessings, these big blessings. And I wonder what the disciples were expecting as Jesus begins his ministry, as they went up there, what they thought he might say. But Jesus starts in with this. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Those who have nothing left to give. Those who have been crushed. That's how I hear the poor in spirit. Blessed are they. For the entire kingdom of heaven is yours. Jesus continues, blessed are those who mourn, those who grieve for something lost. It could be a person, it could be a place, it could be a time. Blessed are they. Not because they're going to figure out what it was all for, right? Or they're going to say, oh, well, now I know why I suffered in such a way. That's not why. Blessed are they because they will be comforted. They will be consoled. Blessed are those who are meek. Now, meek. It's not the same word as weak. I know they rhyme, but they're not the same. Meek is quiet. Submissive, maybe a bit permissive, but not the same as weak. You've heard the phrase, the very old adage, those who live by the sword shall also die by the sword. Well, the meek live in a different way. And they will have different results. Now, it's not always gratifying to us because sometimes we look around the world and we see people getting power through the sword, so to speak, through ways that really are coercive and, in our eyes, unjust. And we think, they sure seem like they have a lot of the earth, don't they? That's not the last word. Because blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Hunger and thirst for righteousness. For they will be filled. Now, this gets even stickier yet. Because we can read righteousness in a lot of ways. A lot of times we read righteousness as sort of the right way of being, and we think about our world, and we think about all the wrong ways our world is going, and we can make long lists. I mean, what was in my head this week was, again, well, I was telling Emma, who's going to lead us in the prayers, when we name a bunch of places, I kept changing that list in the start of the week, and I thought, you know what? I don't know which places we're going to need to name by Sunday morning. name Memphis. We can name a couple of communities in California. We can name the Ukraine, of course. We can name Ethiopia. We can name a lot of places. But those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for the right way of being, it's about more than just what we see in the short term. It's about knowing that God's righteousness is bigger than us, and that we are invited into it again and again, even as sinners, that we are called into God's righteousness, not because we're gathered to be perfect, absolutely not, not because we're gathered to have it all together, because we do not, but because God is good. And so even in these things we gather, and we hear that we are blessed. If you hunger and thirst for righteousness, you are blessed. Blessed are the merciful. Those who remember their own mistakes, I think, and show mercy, for they will receive it. And blessed are the pure in heart. That, for me, feels like the furthest one away. I feel like it gets harder all the time. Because I haven't referenced a song you've never heard in a while, I'm going to do it now. I like metal music. Anyone like metal here? I'm not going to play it for you. But there's this song that it goes through this brutal account of a mercenary, and he says, I've seen it all, and I'm worse off because of it. That's some catharsis for me there. But how many of you feel that way? As you look around, as you look and say, man, oofta. I say that not knowing I say it. That's just how Minnesotan I am. And I will mean it from the bottom of my soul. Yikes. We often feel like we've seen too much. Or perhaps too much of the wrong things. But, as we must name from time to time, it isn't all wrong. It's not all bad. We're very good at finding those things. And we need to be. We need to be people to go into this world as people of blessing and step into these places that Jesus is naming. But say, that's not all. Because blessed are the peacemakers, those who take an active response, those who step out in the world, and yeah, it might be scary because to make peace means you need to go into places that aren't peaceful. Ever think about that? Blessed are you who show up and become decidedly unpopular, who walk into the world and say, blessed are you, and people go, get out of here. That doesn't make any sense. That's foolishness. What are you talking about? Blessed are you when people say that to you on the account of the gospel, of going out into this world that can be very confusing, very unpeaceful, and showing up as a person of blessing, the person who bears the gospel of Christ into a world that is tough and cold. And often cold. Blessed are you. You carry that blessing with you. So as we walk humbly through this world to do justice, to love mercy, we walk with God. That's how we do it. We walk with God knowing that the language we have around who we are and how we're called to be is challenging sometimes. Sometimes we feel like we don't have the right words. We don't know what to say. But go out and proclaim it anyway. Proclaim the cross of Christ. That there is life and redemption in Jesus' name. I know that sounds kind of scary. Kind of like, you know, someone on the corner with a Bible yelling at you. It's not what I'm saying. Proclaim that message of love. That people are loved where they are, as they are. That they are redeemed from all those things that make them feel decidedly not blessed. That's freedom. That's the good news. Go out with our voices together because it's not just the work that we bear on our own shoulders. That's why we gather. That's why we're a community. Because God is still turning it all upside down. And it might be disorienting. Sure. It might be challenging. But blessed all the time. Go out as people of blessing in Jesus' name, knowing that God goes with you as you walk in this world. Amen. We now move into the table where all are fed. So a reminder to all of you joining us at home, this is the table where God's grace meets you. You are welcome at this table. Not because I said so, but because Jesus said so. You can get a cracker, a piece of bread, some juice, and know that God meets you with extraordinary grace in these ordinary things. I invite you to stand as you are able. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Now together as God's people, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. You may be seated. Our servers will come up. You'll be invited forward here in the space. If you wish no one to touch your elements, there are cups right there on the little stands. We have gluten-free wafers and grape juice. If you need those things, please indicate that to your server. And know that God meets you with extraordinary grace in these ordinary things. I will commune with all of you on the recording at the end of our distribution here. And now for all of you gathered at home. This is the body of Christ given for you. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. And now may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace today and forevermore. Amen. Called together to follow Jesus, we pray for the church, the world, and all in need.
Cultivate humility in your church. In gatherings of every size, teach us to boast only in the cross. Shape your church to be people who enact kindness and justice. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
The foundations of the earth bear witness to your faithfulness. The mountains and hills echo with your holiness. Turn us from ways that mistreat your creation. Inspire us with reverent awe to honor all you have made. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
You make foolish the wisdom of the world. Raise up honorable leaders who seek justice, love mercy, and pursue peace. Frustrate plans that are corrupt, wicked, and self-seeking. Prosper the work of peacemakers. Console all who are suffering violence today, especially Half Moon Bay, Monterey Park, Memphis, and those places that we name aloud or in our hearts. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Bless all whom the world rejects. Accompany those who are regarded as foolish, weak, low, and despised. Reveal your power and presence at work where it is least expected. Give your life, strength, and wisdom to all in need, especially those we name, either in our hearts or aloud now. Merciful God,
receive our prayer. Remind this congregation of your saving acts. Remind us how your faithfulness brought us through difficulties and sustained us despite our weaknesses. Establish the cross as the center of our life together. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
We bring our hope, our needs and hopes to you, O God, trusting your wisdom and power revealed in Christ crucified and risen. Amen. We continue our service by receiving an offering and receiving the choir's offering. We give because God has given to us. gathering us today as Vista.
Good morning.
Morning.
My name is Emma Todd. I am one of the Vista Council at-large members, and I have some announcements for the coming weeks. First off, today, the young and young at heart are invited to gather in the narthex area here at the back of the sanctuary to explore the idea of blessing further through a small craft project. Today is also the last day to drop off hats and mittens on the mitten tree. Tomorrow's Monday morning Bible study will meet no matter the temperature, so use your best judgment and bundle up. This Thursday, February 2nd, the Faith Formation mission team needs members, so come at 7 p.m. if you are interested in supporting and leading the education and service learning here at Vista. Looking ahead to next week, next Sunday is Family Sunday School at 9 a.m. And in February, Thursday, February 9th, is Around the Table. Join us for a potluck lunch as we discuss what it means to be rich. Bring rich dishes to share. We'll need the calories this week. Then on Friday, February 10th, we have the Red Cross Blood Drive. You can register online or call the church office to sign up. Same-day registration is not preferred. And then Monday, February 20th, is President's Day, and as many schools are closed, there will be a childcare event here from noon to 4, open for preschool through 6th grade. You can register online. You can find the event on our Facebook page or let Pastor Dan know if you would like to help out. That's all.
Thank you, Emma. Well, as we prepare to go into the world to be people of blessing, we close with our hymn, Rise, Shine, You People. I invite you to stand, or rise, if you will.
Thank you.
bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of God, the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Sanctifier. Amen. Go in peace. Experience God in your lives in unexpected ways. Be a good neighbor. Bless God's world.
I will.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.